sum up the whole Lucy Benjamin thing in EastEnders.
Well, she shot Phil Mitchell, didn't she?
Stories of fight. Yeah, then she kidnapped her daughter.
Then she kidnapped her daughter. Well, she didn't kidnap her daughter because there's a daughter, but she went off. She left Walford.
Portugal.
He didn't know. And then everyone thought he'd murdered her.
Mm. Yes.
You see? Mm. But we knew he hadn't because we knew where she was.
Mm. Anyway, you put all that together, this is what you get.
Look around.
Yeah, great. Unless you want to wipe my nose first.
Mark Fowler, are you proposing to me? I love you, Mark Fowler.
You heard me. I want to see my baby.
And you pointed that gun, you pulled that trigger, you shot me!
No! No, Ace! No, Ace! Never forget me, darling! I love you so much!
You know, why does that upset you?
That really upsets me.
Oh, that's really upset me, yes. Seeing that bit with that Bubba being carried off. Oh, I can't bear it.
And oh. Is that... When you were doing that, you didn't have your little girl, did you?
No, I didn't.
So is that, have you become very emotional since you had
even more so.
And that's your daughter.
I do remember filming that, actually, and the little girl that played the baby then was actually whacking Steve in the back as he was taking her away. And it was obviously traumatised, and she was upset at that point, and I was then, obviously. Mm-hmm. But even more so now, having got Bessie, that's horrible. That's just horrible.
Well, OK, let's talk about the nice things now. 7 years later... Who would have thought?
7 years.
You get the phone call, do you? What happens?
I did. Brian Kirkwood, the exec producer, phoned me and said, would I come back for an episode to tie in with one of the strands of Peggy, Barbara Windsor's leaving storyline?
And, yes.
And I said, yes, you know, right now in my life, that was a nice thing to kind of do, to dip in and dip out, and it was, yeah.
Lovely. Now, tell us what that strand is.
Well...
It's only us listening.
Yeah, right. basically, I think what's happened is Louise has run away from her mum, from Lisa, and I think now wants to see her mum again, having been with her dad for a while, and things are unravelling at home for Lisa and Louise and Phil. And Peggy thinks she's doing the right thing by bringing Louise to Lisa's house to kind of reunite them as such.
Which Phil won't be happy about at all.
No, anything to do with Lisa, he is not happy about. No. He just wants her gone out of the picture. Yeah.
And at the moment, this is just one episode for you.
Yes. Yeah.
Are you telling me the truth?
Yeah. No. Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I didn't think this one was going to happen. So you know, I thought Lisa was gone and it was over and it was all dead and buried. And so I was as shocked as anyone that you know I was phoned up and asked to come back for this one. But
well, this is we'll see you. This is Thursday night's episode. We see you.
Yes.
7:30 BBC One. Let's have a look.
There's someone here to see you.
Lou! Mum! Oh. Oh, my God!
Oh, God! Oh! Lou, darling, why don't you go inside? We'll join you in a minute.
Okay, I don't know what to say. Thank you. Love it.
Brilliant. What a welcome back.
Absolutely.
What was it like, actually, then, reporting for Judy day one, you know, after 7 years?
Well, it's funny because, you know, us actors, every new job is like a first day at school. And so what was lovely, that there was none of those first day at work nerves and you were tangled my coat and knew which office to report to. So that was all great. And walking in, it was like being in a time warp. You know, everyone was the same. The crew was the same. Makeup guys were the same. A lot of cast there still from the old. So it was just bizarre. It was just, you know, time warp time. But it was brilliant. Yeah.
Well, you know. Talking about time warp, I suppose you had to explain where you were for those 7 years to Peggy. And we're going to see that explanation now. Here we go.
Well, we all struggle, Lisa, but some of us don't have the luxury of jetting off when we feel like it.
Peggy, I was having a breakdown. I had no choice but to get away. And just so you know, she weren't just a neighbour, she was my friend. And she promised me she'd take care of Lou until I got back.
I don't believe it.
What, you really think I'd have just left her here to fend for herself?
Then why didn't you get round to Phil's the minute he got off the plane?
Because it was Lou's decision. And I started to think that maybe she was better off without me.
What do you love about soaps? They always have these credible answers to these incredible questions.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's what I liked about doing this storyline, was just that it did explain where Lisa had been, because when I was watching it, I was thinking, where's her mother? Where is Lisa? This is ridiculous. But it makes sense, you know. Mm. She's kind of mentally unstable. She has, you know, times like that. And you know, the little girl is old enough to make her own decisions and say, I want to be with my dad now. So she had no choice but to let her go. And I like that, basically, I was able to come back and defend myself, really, because she was being kind of slaughtered in the square a little bit, I think, for having been a rubbish mum.
And what was life like on the outside in that 7 years? Did you miss the safety net of a soap, or was it good to express yourself and do other things? Was it a mad roller coaster ride? What was it like?
It's all of those, really. I mean, it was never my choice to go in the first place, so the decision was taken out of my hands, and you're very scared at the time about what, you know, what it's going to mean. But having left, you just think, actually, it was a good thing, because I might have been there 100 years later, you know. Mm-hmm. And I have got to do some lovely stuff and have Bessie in the meantime and be a full-time mum. And I don't think, really, I mean, you know, the first 3 years of Bessie's life, I wouldn't have wanted to be that full-on, working that hard.
It's interesting that you say that, because I was reading a piece in the paper today that Emma Thompson, the actress Emma Thompson, is saying about, you know, women can't have it all, or saying don't feel you have to have
it all.
That we're sold this dream that you can have it all. You can be a working mother, you can have a beautiful home, lovely
successful
children, be a fantastic
career,
mother.
Great figure.
And it is something has really to give. Hard.
Something definitely has to give. And, you know, in my career, I did kind of take a back seat, but that's because I wanted to be a hands-on mum. I wanted to be there for Bess. I didn't want to, you know, I was 36 when I had her. And I didn't want to go, here, I've had her now, you bring her up to grandparents or something. I really, really wanted to be there, and I've kind of done that. It's, I mean, I've still got a lot more of that to do.
Of course, but you deserve the break, because, I mean, you were a child actress.
Yeah, nine when I started.
Nine.
40 now, yeah.
Goodness
so, you know, I have been acting a long time, and not that I've got the T-shirt and been there and all that, but, I just felt I'd never had a child, and that was something I wanted to explore and nurture.
Well, look, we look forward to seeing. It's going to be Thursday night on EastEnders for one night only.
He is back.
Yeah, Lisa Fowler's back. Lisa Benjamin, lovely talking
and
to you.
Thank you very much. I want you to try that monkfish recipe this weekend.
Yeah, right.
I know.
More recipes tomorrow. Also, we're talking about...